The scene of that Manhattan steam pipe explosion. The pipe blew yesterday.
Passionate songs of love, both requited and wonderful spirit of the Neapolitan city and its people, their way of life and their exuberance, their passion and their romance, through the perennial charm of Neapolitan song. As Pavarotti returns to Naples.
Napoli, my wonderful Naples, like Caruso used to say. I am so happy to be here again after 12 years. I will sing a concert at the Opera House, the glorious San Carlo. In the program, of course, several Neapolitan songs. They are all speaking of love, but Naples is not just that. I have sung those songs all over the world, and you cannot know this music without coming to know the wonderful spirit of the city. Seeing the city again, I am excited. I am like the man in the song, O Paese do Sole. He is a Neapolitan who must leave the city to make his fortune. He becomes a success, but he is so unhappy. He returns to Naples.
Sto tanto allegro che quasi quasi me ne tessa piangerebbe sta felicità. Ma è vero, non è vero, caso tornata a Napoli, ma è vero che sto qua. O treno stava ancora in la stazione quando agintise prima maledurine.
Stop!
Naples is a city like no other. It is very Italian, but also Spanish, Oriental, and even a little African. Neapolitan have lived under the Greeks, Spanish, the French, but never really under anyone. There is much here of great beauty, but nothing as beautiful as the people themselves. Even in the poorest section, you see a nobility and a self-respect you don't find in other cities, and the love of life.
Stai lontana da stupore, e a te volo co pensiero, niente voglio, niente spero, da tenerte sempre a fianco a me. Sii sicura che sto amore, come so se cure te. Notte non te vedo, non te siento in tratte braccia, non te baso questa faccia, non te stringo forte in braccia a me. Ma se tanto mi sto sonno, me fai piangere per te.
Many Neapolitans live their lives in the street. It is not they don't like their home, but they like drama and they don't want to waste it at home. They take it on the street and always with music. The classic Neapolitan song will not fade away or survive only in concert halls. They turn up everywhere. It is the Cittincello Buie, a classic and passionate love song. Tell your friend, I cannot sleep. I love Earth so much. But love songs come in all forms. Even the march tempo of Soldato Innamorato.
Io non penso che a te sola, nul pensiero me consola, ca non vien se sulla venta a me. Ma più belle tutte belle, non è mai più bella e te. Hai vita mia, hai cuore.
Sarà per me.
The small fishing harbor of Santa Lucia is the heart of Naples. Two of the greatest songs have been written about it, Santa Lucia and Santa Lucia Lontana. Both are passionate love songs to the city of Naples. For the Neapolitan songwriter, Naples is Santa Lucia. Today, Santa Lucia has many restaurants that are very popular with tourists. But it is still an harbor for fishermen. Their boats go out on sunrise every morning, so you are sure to have fresh fish if you eat here. Neapolitans are very religious people, and you cannot walk very far in the city without passing a church or a shrine. In Santa Lucia, there is a shrine for the fishermen, so they can pray for good luck and pray the Virgin will keep them safe on the water. Next to the Santa Lucia statue of La Madonna are the words, "Without me, you can do nothing." In Naples, the Madonna speaks plainly, and for the most part, the Neapolitans listen. But for most people, Santa Lucia is a place for good food, good time, good friends. When people come to eat here, they want to hear Neapolitan songs. And nothing is too corny or sentimental. Singers of the classic song appear in all the restaurants. They are in Neapolitan tradition. Proud men who have become the high priest of this music. Music is not the only reason to come to Santa Lucia. People come to drink the white wine from Vesuvio Lacrima Christi or the red wine from Capri. They come to eat the great specialità napoletana spaghetti alle vongole, pasta made with a fantastic little clam. They do not like traveling, not even to Rome. You must eat them right here in Naples. Another favorite dish is the fried calamari, or spaghetti alla puttanesca, named in honor of the ladies who made their living in the street. The idea is, this sauce is simple. Just black olive, tomato, garlic, and capers. So it can be made quickly by busy career women. Neapolitan songs sing about love, even love for the city. They are for all Italians, the music of homesickness, la mancanza di casa. One of the most beautiful is about a Neapolitan who must leave Italy and is said to be so far from Santa Lucia. The song has meaning for all the Italians. But it has a special meaning for the million who have made home in country all over the world. Thank you. I think this pride of all the Italians who have gone out into the world and their fantastic accomplishments. But I am even prouder to think that they never forget or lose their love for Italy. Like most of the new generation everywhere, the Neapolitan loves rock and roll and other pop music. Doesn't mean that they don't like the traditional form, but sometimes they prefer their own version. In Naples, they can sing about anything, and sing in any style. Funiculi Funicola, one of the most famous songs in the world, was written to celebrate the opening of the cable car to Vesuvio in 1884. And while mass transit is not a typical subject for a song, even here the composer worked in the subject of love. He says how he would rather face the danger of the volcano than the temper of his girlfriend down below. But rather you sing it with a rock beat or the traditional way like I do, the song has all the energy and exuberance of Naples today or any time. In fact, the only thing that has changed here since the time of Adam is the traffic.
E chiusa poi è tornata e poi è venuta, sta sempre qua.
Through history, the sea has been important to Italians. We love it and we know how to use it. Don't forget it was an Italian across the Atlantic to prove the world round and, in the process, discover America. Most of Italy's population lives on the sea or near it. As soon as we have some vacation, we go right to the water. Because the city of Naples is built on a hill overlooking the water, the people here always have a blue, blue Mediterranean. And many Neapolitans make their living from the sea. A beautiful song, Marinariello, is about a young fisherman, in love, of course. He likes being a fisherman, and he likes even more the end of the day when he will see his woman. It is a simple but passionate hymn to life. Beside the sea, I will make love. I am a young fisherman. I pull in my nets, and I am so happy I could die.
We'll be back in a moment with more of our festival celebration here on 13. During our brief intermission, give us a call and pledge your support for a
Naples is full of beautiful women. all types, all size, all sexy. For 70 years, men have been singing to this Neapolitan woman, Marie. There must have been a real Marie. I wonder what she looked like. I wonder if she's still here. There is so much love in Naples, it is natural some of it doesn't go well. Fighting between lovers is common all over the world, but in Naples it is a form of art. We Italians have seen so much war in 2000 years, we don't like it much anymore. Maybe that is why we prefer to have battle with people we love. Many Neapolitan songs are about the pain of love. The song may be angry or sad, the situation tragic or comic, but always the music is beautiful. And an Italian knows how to fight beautifully, just like in the movie.
Crescerà l'aria tutto lo giardino adurava le rose a cento passi. Era de marzo, io no, non me ne scordo, la canzone cantava la tua voce. Più tempo passa e più me la ricordo. Crescerà e diceva cuore, cuore, cuore mio lontano vai, tu me lasciai a volto l'ore, chissà quando tornarai, rispondeva io, tornaraggio, quando tornerò. Se fosse gioia mia, e
For a century, Napoli was a poor city. Many people here have known very hard times, and you can see it in their eyes. They know how it can be. The best-loved Neapolitan songs come from a time of hardship and much poverty. Not only great music came from this bad condition, but great singing too. The greatest tenor of all the time, Enrico Caruso, was born in Naples to a very poor family. His apartment is still here. Another family lives there now. But a group of Neapolitans is trying to make it a museum, and I hope I am able to help them. It moved me very much to visit Caruso's birthplace. To go up the same steps he went up every day, to see the room in which he was born, made me cry. It was not very different from the house I grew up in. One of the finest Neapolitan songs is Mare Chiaro by Tosti, which is about a simple fishing village outside of Naples. When I sing this song in concert around the world and look at audience in their fine clothes and jewelry, I think of that shabby village and the poor young man who serenade his love from under her window. The boy is poor, the audience may be rich, but music, as we all know, breaks down any barriers.
Oh.
Many people know this song, and when they go to Naples, they go to see the famous window at Mare Chiaro. There is a legend that the girl in the song jumped from her window into the shallow water below, and her body was never found. Perhaps because Neapolitans love life so much, they think a lot about death. They have lived with earthquake, plagues, and war. And always there is Vesuvio, that terrible, beautiful volcano that is a constant reminder that death can happen at any moment. The city has magnificent cemeteries which are tended with love and respect. They are always filled with fresh flowers to show that the Neapolitans do not just put up monuments, then forget about them, but visit the graves often. Family bonds are very strong in Naples, and they do not end with death. It is natural that some of the most haunting Neapolitan songs are about death and loved ones who have died. One of the loveliest is Fenesta che Luciva. It's tell of a young girl who gets sick and dies. Her boyfriend goes to her house and look up at her window that once was lit, but is now dark.
Per la
Some people who write theories of music say all music begins with the human voice. It is certainly the beginning of Neapolitan music. You hear singing everywhere, in markets, coming from the window, in the street. And with that rich Neapolitan dialect, it is hard to tell where talking stops and singing begins. Oh, sole mio is a song for a workman to sing by himself. For centuries, farmers, fishermen, and others worked long hours alone. They passed the time and got out their feeling by singing with no one to hear them. In the time I spent in Naples, I got to know the people much better and came to realize how wonderful they are. They don't claim to be perfect. In fact, I think they are a little in love with their defects. Toward the end of my visit, I told my driver that I had come to like the people in this city very much. He was an older man who always lived here. He shook his head and said, "You have terrible taste. Maybe I do in something, but not in people." Does anyone miss their country more than we Italians? Maybe, but no one sings about it as much as we do. Wherever I sing around the world, I always include one of the most famous songs about longing for Italy. It is about Sorrento, a beautiful town on cliff above the sea, just south of Naples. Thank you. The song is actually about a young man who is unhappy because his girlfriend is leaving him in Sorrento. His song is pleading with her to return. But the song became really symbolic of everyone who wants to return to Sorrento. Come back to Sorrento. Come back home.
Tu dici o fare tu addio.